Hi to all. Today we are going to discuss about transformer output equation. Okay, in this chapter we are going to see about single phase output, single phase transformer output equation. Before going to output equation, we should know what is transformer. Okay, transformer is an electrical device which by the principle of electromagnetic induction transfer electrical energy from one electric circuit to another without changing the frequency. The energy transfer usually takes place with a change of voltage and current. Transformers either increase the voltage or decrease the voltage. Okay, if it is a step-up transformer, there are used between power generators and the power grids. The secondary output voltage will be always greater than input voltage. So in generating station, normally we generate the power of 11 kV, but the same voltage we can't transfer for a long distance. There we are going for step up transformer, step down transformer. This transfer power we can't directly use for domestic as well as industry purpose. There we need step down transformer. Step down transformer, the voltage level will be stepped down. Power transformers, where we need increase the power, that is from the generating station, we need power transformers. Distribution transformers, which is used in domestic as well as industry purpose. Okay, these are the small introduction for the transformer. Now we go for output equation of transformer. Before going to output equation of transformer, let some of the what we called symbolic representation we should know before going for output equation of transformer. Pi m is the main flux, its unit is webers. Bm is the maximum flux density, its unit is webers per meter square. Ai is the iron core area, net iron core area. Ac is the copper area of copper in the window, its unit is meter square. Aw, window area, its unit is meter square. Del is the current density, its unit is ampere per meter square. A small gi, gross core area, its unit is meter square. Capital D is the distance between the limbs, core centers. Normally they call core centers, it's a limbs, between limbs. Okay, small d, dia of circumferencing circle, its unit is m or meter. Okay, kw is nothing but windows space factor, and f is the frequency, its unit is hertz. And ei, emf per turn, its unit is voltage v. And tp, ts, the term t mentions turns. Okay, so number of turns in primary and number of turns in secondary respectively. Ip and is nothing but current in primary and current in secondary respectively. Vp and vs, terminal voltage of primary and secondary voltage respectively, its unit is voltage. Ap, as, area of conductors of primary and secondary windings respectively, its unit is meter square. Li, mean length of flux path in iron, its unit is meters. Lmt, length of mean turn of transformer winding, its unit is meters. Gi, weight of active iron, so its unit is kilogram. Gc, weight of copper, its unit is also kilogram. Small gi, weight per meter cube of iron, its unit is kg. Similarly, small gc, weight per meter cube, of copper, it is also in kilogram. Pi, loss in iron per kg, its unit is watts. Pc, loss in copper per kg, its unit also in watts. Now we go for single phase output equation of single phase transformer. The voltage induced in a transformer winding with T turns and excited by source having a frequency f hertz is given by voltage per turn ET is equal to E by capital T. That value is equal to 4.44. Okay, how we are getting that value? We know E is the output, E is equal to 4.44 f pi m and ET. So from this we can get ET is equal to, that is E by T is equal to 4.44 f into pi m. Okay, the window in a single phase transformer contains one primary and one secondary winding. Okay, in the previous semesters what we seen, normally the transformers having primary in one side, secondary in another side, but in practically it will not like that. In the same limb, primary winding as well as secondary winding will be present in both the sides. Why they are making like this means to reduce the flux leakage. To reduce flux leakage, normally the transformers are wounded in the primary as well as secondary in both the limbs. Now we see the total copper area in window AC is equal to copper area of primary winding plus copper area of secondary winding, that is primary turns into area of primary conductor plus secondary turns into area of secondary conductors. So we can write TP AP plus TS AS. So AC is equal to TP AP plus TS AS. Taking the current density del to be the same in the both the primary and secondary windings, so we can write AP is equal to IP by del as well as AS is equal to IS by del. So the total conductor area in window AC is equal to TP IP by del plus TS IS by del. In this equation del is common for both the things, so we can write TP IP plus TS IS by del. So we know the value of AC is equal to 280 by del. Okay, because TP IP, let us consider TP IP is equal to 80, so both the things TS IS also 80, so 80 plus 80 by del, we can write 280 by del. Let us consider this is the equation number 2. The ratio of copper area in window to area of window, okay, KW, window's factor is equal to conductor area in window AC, okay, divided by total area of window AW. So the conductor area in window AC is equal to KW AW. So from this equation, okay, KW is equal to AC by AW. From this, AC is equal to KW AW. From equation 2 and 3, from this equation, this is equation 2 and this is equation 3. 280 by del is equal to KW AW. So AT is equal to KW AW del by 2. Rating of single phase transformer in KVA. So Q is equal to VP IP VI. So P is equal to VI. Here Q is equal to VP IP. Primary voltage, primary current into the number of minus 3. This is the output equation. So EP IP into 10 to the power of minus 3. Why you are making instead of VP to EP? VP is the supply voltage and EP is the supply voltage, VP is the primary voltage. So both the values VP and EP are more or less equal. So we can write EP IP into 10 to the power of minus 3. So ET TP. So we know EP is nothing but ET into TP. So substitute the value of this one. See this one. From this, we can write ET TP IP into the power of minus 3. Okay, we know TP IP is nothing but AT. So we can rewrite the equation ET into AT into 10 to the power of minus 3, the value. Okay, so we know what is AT from this. AT is equal to KW AW delta by 2. Substitute the value of that one and we substitute the value of ET. ET is nothing but 4.44 pi m into f into the value of AT KW AW delta by 2 into the power of minus 3. So if we simplify this one, we will get 2.22 f pi m KW AW delta into 10 to the power of minus 3. But pi m is the maximum flux density multiplied with net core area. So bm into ai. Okay, so we rewrite the equation q is equal to 2.22 f bm del kw aw ai into 10 to the power of minus 3. This is the output equation of here. Single phase transformer. Thank you.